Welcome, my dear students. Today we are going to be learning our last chapter, that is file management in C. This is a very very important topic, so you have to give more attention on this chapter, okay? Because part C programs exist, so you have to give more attention on this chapter, okay? Let us see. Today many computer applications or programs require to store and process a large volume of data, right? Any computer application or a program requires a huge amount of storage data for processing of your data, okay? If you want to process a huge data, I must have sufficient memory, sufficient space. So far we have been using scanf and printf function to input and output data. So till now we have learned, to input the data we are using the scanf function, to output the data we are using the printf function. These functions are console oriented input output function and use keyboard and screen as their target. As we know, by using the scanf function you are inputting the data through from the keyboard, and by using the printf function you are displaying the data in your screen. Yes, so that is why it is called as a console. Console means your input and outputs, okay? Input and output functions. These functions are useful until input or output data is small. So how long this printf and scanf will alpha? If your data is very small, then it is fine. As the input or output data increases, these function pose certain limitations, okay? It means if you are going to be storing a huge data, if you are inputting huge data, then this printf and scanf is having certain drawbacks, okay? Let us see what are those drawbacks. It is very difficult to input large volume of data through keyboard using scanf function. If you want to insert a huge amount of data, then it is not possible by using scanf. It is a time consuming to type input data if the input data is large. If the input data is large, automatically it will time consume. The entire input data is lost when either the computer is turned off or the program is terminated due to any reason. So if you are while inputting your data, if the power offs, automatically whatever the data is exist, it will lost, okay? Right. So to overcome these drawbacks, printf and scanf is to use files on secondary storage device like or disk, magnetic tapes, CDs, floppy or pen drive to store a program input or output data permanently. So to overcome the drawbacks of the above, then what I have to do? I have to store the large volume of data in the form of a file, okay? So then where these files are storing? These files are storing such devices like your hard disk. For example, I have opened this file, chapter 16, right? This is a Word file, right? It consists of a huge data. Then where it is exist? In my pen drive, got it? In the same sense, in your computers, we are storing a huge amount of data, right? Your gaming data, your movie data, your audio data, or your celebrations data, your whatever the data is, it requires a storage. And we must have a mechanism of storing data permanently, okay? So that is possible by using the concept in your C through files concept. While running the program, the file containing input data is submitted as input the program, okay? Whenever you are executing the files program, then you are running at the runtime, you are submitting the input data to your program. Similarly, the program output can be stored permanently in a file instead of directly displaying it on the screen, okay? So instead of displaying the output on the screen, data will be stored permanently in a form of a file, okay? Till now we are seeing file. I hope you have already learned in your FIT. Now let us see what is a file. A file is a place on external storage device where a group of related data is stored permanently. So it is a place, on an external storage device. As you know, what is an external storage device? It is a hard disk or your pen drives or any compacted disk, floppy disk, and so on. Okay, by using this storage device, then what you are doing? You are storing a group of related data. What do you mean by group of related data? If you take any one of a book, that book consists of that subject information, right? Suppose if you have taken a ANSYS Balaguru Swami, it consists of C programming concept, right? If you take a fundamentals of IT, then it consists of fundamentals of IT data. That is called as related data, relevant data. So that is stored permanently. So in computer system, if you want to store any files permanently, it must require a space in your storage device. Okay, it is also called as unit of computer storage. Then file is also called as, this question is asked, so please give more attention. It is also called as unit of computer storage. So for example, if you see this chapter 16, right, it is in my pen drive, right? You are identifying here 64 KB, so it consumes some bytes of memory, right? That is the same thing here. It is suggesting unit of computer storage. Okay, in a file, the related data are organized as records, whatever the relevant informations. Then how we are arranging? Organizing means arranging. We are arranging in the form of a records. Okay, and a file can also be defined as set of records. So then what is the file is also defined? A file is also consist of a set of records. Okay, for example, a student file may contain one record for each student. Okay, if I'm taking your data, so every student has admitted, you are having your own roll numbers, right? So it is I'm treating as a student file. So while conducting your exams, we have posted your roll numbers, right? You have seen the data is arranged, right? The file is arranged. Okay, it consists of one name. Got it? I'm treating here the file name is a student, and here it consists of a field: serial number, student name, student class, student address, fees. This is called the headings. In computer terms, these headings are called as fields. For these relevant fields, you are entering the relevant data. In serial number, you are entering only the serial number, right? You are not entering the name of a student in serial number. Got it? So that is why you are entering the relevant data in these fields. Then one horizontal row, this one horizontal row of information gives a particular student, gives the information of a particular student. So this horizontal row of information is nothing but a record. Okay, yes, clear? Hope you are understanding this concept, right? So here, for example, a student file may contains one record for each student. For each student, it consists of one record. Each record should be composed of these fields. Here it has been composed as these fields. Okay, yes. Now we will see types of files. What are the types of files exist in computer systems? Okay, here we are having two types of files. Now you are seeing here physically appearing as chapter 13, chapter 14, chapter 15 and chapter 16, right? Here physically we have stored these chapter 13, chapter 14, chapter 15 and chapter 16 in the form of a file of a unit 4 folder, but it is a storing in the form of a text based information. It is appearing, right? But computer can understand in the form of binary files. Okay, so let us see what are the types of files. One is the text files, where data is represented as stream of characters. Then how does this text files will be represented? This text file will be represented in the form of stream of characters, as we have seen now, chapter 13, 14, 15 and 16. This is the text file. Data will be represented. How the data is representing? See, I am opening this chapter 16. Here the data is appearing in the form of a text, right? It is a consist of characters. What is the text? Set of characters. Got it? And next one is binary files, where data is represented in the same way as it is represented in the computer memory. Then binary files, it is represented in the same way it is represented in the computer memory. Then how the computer memory is represented? In the form of stream of bits, that is zeros and ones. So the information of binary files is appear in the form of zeros and ones only. Okay, the C language is more flexible in handling files. So by using this C programming language, it is more flexible in handling files. It provides number of function to perform file processing activities or file operation. By using these functions of files, we can able to calculate many operations. Okay, for example, you are touching, you are opening even application WhatsApp, right? Then what is the code behind that opening file? Some of these functions. So these are the basics. Okay, even you are using the Android operating system, you are touching, you are opening some of the apps in your smartphones, right? So the basic behind that coding system is these kinds of functions. Okay, now let us see file handling functions. So this is also very, very important. It will be asked in your 2 months as well as 6 months questions. So please give more attention on that. Okay, now first function is fopen function. By using this fopen function, we can use it to open a file. By using this function, I can open a file. Okay, fclose. So after your all the work, what we are doing, we are closing this file, right? So to close a file, we have to suppose to use a function called fclose. Next one is getc function. Already you are familiar. Let us see once again. You have learned in your first unit and it is coming here once again. Let us give more attention on this. Okay, getc function used to write a single character into a open file. So then what is the purpose of a getc function? Here write means to store. Okay, used to write means it is used to store a single character in an open file. Whatever the file you have opened, it will be store a single character. Next one is putc function. By using this putc function, used to read a single character from a open of file. Okay, so then what is the purpose of a putc function? Actually it is a display function. Here read means to access. Whatever you have stored in by using the getc function in a file, if you want to access that character, then your reading means to access. Okay, so to access a character from a open file, then we have to suppose to use putc function. Now these two functions are very, very important function. One is fscanf function. By using this fscanf function, it is used to write mixed data in an open file. By using this fscanf function, I can able to store mixed kind of data. As we know, what are the various kinds of data is available? Integer data, character data, float data, double data, string data, array data, structures data, right? All these are the different kinds of data. If you want to store mixed kind of data, for example, in the above figure you are seeing, serial number, it is an integer data. Student name, it is a character array data. Student class, it is a character array data. Student address, it is a character data. Fee, it is a right integer data. And if I mention gender, if you are specifying M or F, then it is a character data, right? So such kinds of a mixed data can be used to store your writing. Okay, writing means we have to store. Then where we are storing? In a open file. And next our function is fprintf function. So by using this fprintf function, we can read. Read means accessing. We are accessing the stored mixed data in a file, right? What we are accessing? The stored mixed data in a open file. If you want to access, then you have to use fprintf function. Next, our function is getw function. Use it to write an integer into a open file. So then what is the purpose of get w? If you want to store an integer value in an open file, then we have to suppose to use get w function. Then what about the put w? It is used to read integer from a open file. So by using the open file concept, if you have opened any file, if you have stored any integer value in that file, if you want to access that integer data, then we have to suppose to use put w function. And next, these functions are also very very important. Let us see fevof. Fevof stands for end of file. Fevof stands for end of file. By using that, we are checking whether the file end of mark, whether the file came to end or not. Okay, for example, you have taken the 100 page or 50 page notes book. Okay, if the 50 page as you have written, if it is finished, then what happens? We can able to identify the book as finished. Suppose if you finished only one page, then how to identify that one page of information you have finished? By using this fevof function. So it means I'm identifying whenever I'm storing my data, and I am identifying where the last record has ended. Okay, where the lost record has ended. And next function is ftel function. By using this ftel function, returns the current position of a file pointer in the file pro. Right, for example, now you are seeing this mouse. This is an insertion point. Where does this insertion point is exist here? Right, so suppose when you are writing your notes on your book, then what you are doing? You are continuing the writing, right? Whenever you write, updating your notes, then where the pen point will go, where the last position has ended, then you are continuing from that position, right? So here it is also the same thing. By using this ftel function, I am identifying the file pointer current position in the file. File pointer current position in the file. Okay, for example, nowadays CDs, right? So you are using CDs. If you are listening the songs, then what you are doing? Best example is ftel function. Yes, CDs. If you are having a songs of 500 or 1000 songs in your CD, if you are accessing that, if your favorite song is exist in 500, then by using this ftel function, what you are doing, you are identifying currently which song is playing, right? Got it? So if you want to access the 500th 250th song is your favorite song, you have to listen till to 249th song, right? So first day you have accessed 10 songs, and the second day you are accessing 20 songs. Likewise, it is happening, but nowadays you are directly accessing your favorite song, right? So that is means you are moving your pointer to your current location, to your desired location. What you are doing? You are making the movement, just like as a your remote. In your remote, you are pressing your favorite channel number. When you press the favorite channel number, from the current channel to it will move. But here, by using this ftel function, I can identify where the file pointer position is exist. Okay, and next one is the rewind. So sets the file pointer to the beginning of the file. So if you once turn off your system, then you turn on your system, automatically you are watching your favorite channel as rewinds, correct? When you turn on your system, what happens? It will start from the beginning of the file. Okay, so after writing your notes, if you close your book, what happens? Once again, if you want to open your book, you are starting from the starting page itself only, right? So that means rewind function. By using this rewind function, you are setting the file pointer to the beginning of the file. Okay, and next function is fError function. By using this fError function, you are going to be detect invalidates file operation, means any error occur in file operations. Okay, so by using this FERROR function, you are identifying the error occurred in your file operation. So these are the dual functions are very, very important. You have to give more attention on these functions. Okay, what is a fopen? This fopen function is used to open a file. Fclose is used to close a file. Getc used to write a character into a open file. Putc used to access a single character from a open file. Fscan used to store mixed data into an open file. Fprintf used to read mixed data from a open file. Getw used to write an integer into an open file. Putw used to access an integer from an open file. Fendof used to check for a file. End of a mark. Ftel returns the current position of the file pointer in the file. Rewind sets the file pointer to the beginning of the file. Ferrer used to detect invalid file operation. Okay, yes. Now let us see what are the file operations or file processing activities. By using these files, what we are able to perform. First one is declaring file pointer. If you want to access any file, if you want to access any nodes, first you have to create that nodes, right? In the same sense, if you want to access the file concept in your C program, then you have to declare the file pointer. And second one is opening a file. After declaring the file pointer, you are opening a file. And third, so what are the file operations we are able to performing on these files? First one is you have to declare a file pointer. Second one is you have to open a file. Third one is reading data from a file. So you have to access data from a file. And fourth one is writing data to a file, to store a data to a file. And fifth one is closing a file. These are the file operations we are going to be performing in your C program. Okay, what are the five operations we are performing? One is declaring a file pointer. Second one is opening a file. Third one is writing a data to a file. And fourth one is reading a data from a file. And fifth one is closing a file. Okay, so we will continue this file operations in the next class.